dance with us. Come on, get up and clap your hands.
Praise the hallelujah.
Come on, you're also getting a workout.
Every
a spiritual and a physical yes. workout.
I raise a hallelujah. I will watch the darkness flee.
Yes.
I raise a hallelujah.
Roba sakra roba sentere de de de. Come on, that's right. Lift lift him up, lift him up, lift him up, lift him up, lift him up. That's right. Come on. We come to lift him up. Come on, Monday praise. Come on, that's right. Monday miracles. Monday move. It's happening. There's no blue Mondays. We're going to praise him. Oh, I raise a hallelujah.
I raise a hallelujah.
Come on, raise a hallelujah with us.
I raise a hallelujah.
If you raise a hallelujah, they will raise a hallelujah with you. Come on, it's right. Whoa. Your praise is not on lockdown. Your worship is not on lockdown. We will enter his gates with thanksgiving. We will come into his courts with praise. We will lift up the name of Jesus. Come, can we clap our hands a bit? The Bible says, clap your hands, all you people. Shout unto God with a voice of triumph.
Good morning, everybody.
Are you excited this morning to join us?
It's Monday.
Yes.
His mercy is on you every morning.
That's right. That's right. As you can see, we have our beautiful Love Church t-shirts on. Hallelujah. But we also have the globe here. We want to pray for the world this morning. Come on, there was a request, you know, and there's so many testimonies coming in. We are so excited. This is only day four.
Yeah.
Day four, and we believe it's going to just increase and increase.
Yes.
But I also want to encourage you as you keep praising God and as you keep worshiping God. But there was a few requests actually that came in for a good punkster song. People want to do some punkster dance. Now, obviously, we're a bit limited for space and limited for, you know, in front of the camera. But you are not limited right there. You can move. You can dance in the kitchen. You can dance in the wherever you want to dance right now. But we're going to put a song on and we're going to do Boom, Takumi Yeredia. One of our very own artists here in Cape Town, South Africa, Neville D. And I believe most of you know the song. Because we wanted to be careful what song we choose. Because we don't just want to sing Afrikaans. Because again, we have people viewing us from everywhere.
Yes.
New Zealand, Australia, there's people from Malaysia. Come on, we are trusting God for breakthroughs.
Come on.
But we're going to do the song and I want you to get your dance shoes ready.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
Ali, slippers off now. Take the slippers off now and get ready to praise him. Come on. Because this one says God is going to come through very suddenly. Come on, that's right. Like the scripture we were reading, Acts 16, suddenly the Lord came through. Are you ready? Come on, take your moves now.
Netsu, Netsu, Diara Vitu, Netu, Netu, or say no, no, Netsu, 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 Diara Vitu, Netu, Netu,
Yes. Some water.
Good morning, everybody.
Hallelujah.
Joining us. God is good, amen.
I think we should do more of those songs so we have a workout.
Woo!
Hallelujah. Spiritual and a physical
exercise.
Workout. Hallelujah.
Yeah, God is faithful, amen.
Hallelujah.
Hope you had a good night's rest.
Yes.
We had an awesome time last night, amen.
Yes.
So many testimonies that came in.
That's right.
Wow, I just want to mention a few testimonies that came in. There was a testimony of a woman that actually contacted us. She was struggling with pain for a long time, from her head all down in her body. And
yes.
She said that God healed her from that pain. Come on.
Yeah.
God healed her from that pain.
Yeah.
And she had an encounter, a deliverance encounter last night with the Lord. And then there was lower backs that were healed. Knees were healed.
Yeah.
And someone sent me a message and said, I just felt the presence of the Lord. I feel transformed. I feel changed. Isn't God awesome?
Yeah.
Isn't he amazing? Yes. God is just giving a praise for what he's doing.
Yes.
And today is a new day.
Yes.
We like to start the day with a new word, with a fresh word, because we believe the way we start the week is the way it's gonna, just progress.
Yes.
And so this morning, I just want to decree to this Monday.
Come on.
And so, Lord, I thank you that Monday is a new day. Your mercies are new.
Yes.
Every morning we come with great expectation on this Monday. So we just decree and declare that our Monday, our Tuesday, our Wednesday, our Thursday, our Friday, our Saturday will be blessed in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
I thank you, Father, in this week that you will just pour out your Spirit. I thank you this week that we will see miracles, Father God. I thank you, Lord, that you're going to do signs and wonders, Father. I thank you in this week, Father, that you will just deliver good news. I decree good news. I decree good reports. I just decree, Father God, open doors, Lord, of opportunity, Father God. I decree, Lord, that your children are blessed. I decree that they are protected. I decree that they are provided for. I decree, Lord, in this hour that there will be salvations, Father God. I decree, Lord, to this COVID-19 that the numbers will decrease in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare, Father God, that this demonic force will have no hold, this body bondage, of sickness, this bondage of plague, Father God, will have no control, no hold over our lives, over our minds, Lord, over this nation, Father God. And so I decree and declare that COVID-19 numbers will decrease in the name of Jesus. As so, a Father, I pray that this week will experience a fresh outpouring. I pray for your children. I pray for those watching. I thank you, Lord, that this week they will witness miracles in their homes. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen,
hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Wow. Yes. There are so many people already logged on, commenting. Thank you so much. Share, invite. You know, share with your friends, your family right now. Somebody needs a word out there. You know, we just decided to do this by faith, and wow, we thank God that we decided to obey Him. Remember, obedience are better than sacrifice.
That's right.
And I want to encourage you, when the Holy Spirit speaks to you, obey Him. Just obey Him.
Yeah.
You might not understand exactly all the details. Yeah. Just obey Him, and you're going to see what He is going to do.
Yeah.
But welcome, welcome again. Wow, that workout, that song, that dance is no jokes. And I feel we need to do another one.
We will be posting some workouts later today. And also there's somebody that's going to teach us some French.
Yeah.
So I'll be posting that video throughout the day. So please go onto our Facebook page or share, like, and just invite others, because we're going to put some fun things on our Facebook page.
Come on, that's right.
Well.
You have to be creative while you're at home. I was watching our brother David, as he's joined in there. David Malila, he's a runner. And he's a man that runs 42 kilometers. And and you know what? Right now he's running in his yard. He's running around the house.
Yeah.
He's running around the pool. Crazy. He's jumping over the dog, you know. So who let the dog out? So just, you know, be creative and just do some fun stuff with your family.
Yes.
And before you realize it, these 21 days are over. But while we are in lockdown, we are not locked down, as our spirit and our praise is not locked down. And God is going to give you great ideas in this 21 days.
That's right. I just want to tag on what my husband was saying about obedience. About obedience is better than sacrifice.
Yes,
and yesterday, the Lord was just speaking to me about Noah and building the ark.
Yes.
And how Noah obeyed every instruction from God.
That's right.
Because God prepared him for a lockdown.
Yes.
And so Noah, he followed, and he said Noah did everything as the Lord commanded. But also about the ark of presence.
Yes.
And just about, and then we had someone commenting yesterday to say the Lord is taking us back to the ark of His presence. And I said, wow, because the Lord just gave me that. And I feel like in His presence, we are secured. We are safe.
That's right.
So I would encourage you to stay, build an ark.
Yes,
home, an ark, your room, your prayer room, an ark of His presence,
that's
and stay there, because in His presence you are protected.
Yes.
And it was for 40 days and 40 nights, you know, that they were in lockdown. But God had prepared them. God had given them specific instructions.
That's right.
And God is going to give you specific instructions in this hour.
That's right.
And so I want to encourage you, follow that instructions, because God wants to protect you.
Yes.
God wants to show His glory to you in this hour.
That's
in
right.
Jesus' name.
Wow, that's so amazing. So, you know, there are so many testimonies. We want to share a few of the testimonies. Wow, last night, our hour of power. Wow,
we had such,
we never got, in fact, we were going to do Boom Da Kumi Yere there last night.
Yeah.
But it wasn't on God's agenda. So we have to just flow with the Holy Spirit. But we had so many testimonies coming in.
Yes.
We had such a powerful time in the presence of God. We had prophecy, and we believe that every day this is going to be a free flow.
Yes.
Come on, we come prepared. We have notes. We have a structure, but we are not bound to that structure.
Yeah.
We're just going to flow with the Holy Ghost. And we can't even say to you, this is going to be 20 minutes or 30 minutes. We just want to flow with the Holy Spirit.
Right.
Amen. Is that all right?
That's right?
So just be open wherever you are right now. Come on
in.
And as my wife was praying, I'm thinking of everyone right now that's tuned in, that's locked in. I want to just release a word over you. Come on. The Bible says in Deuteronomy 28 that you are blessed coming in, and
you
are blessed going out. And that the blessing of God will
blessed.
Be upon you. It will follow you, and it will even overtake you.
That's right.
And that's right now what I want to speak. I want to speak the blessing of the Lord over you, over your family, over your loved ones. I want to cancel every assignment
of the
enemy. I declare that no weapon that's formed against you shall prosper. I speak right now that the presence of the Lord will locate you, and that you will, the angels of God is assigned and released to your house, to your address right now. Come on, the angels know your GPS location right now, and in the Spirit of the Lord is ministering to you. You are not going to be the same after these 21 days. Come on, God is already transforming people. Your priorities are changing, and we release that word over you. Come on, Psalm 23, that goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life. Amen.
You know, last night I had a dream. I shared with my husband, I had a dream, and there was two in the dream, there were two women that came to me.
Yes.
And these two women asked me, what do you think that the Lord is doing right now in this hour? Or what do you sense?
Yes.
What's happening right now in this hour? And I replied to this lady, and I don't know her in the dream, I don't know her.
Yes.
And I said to her, there is a war at the moment in the spiritual realm. There's a war between heaven and hell.
Yeah.
And I said to her, there's like a tug of war
come
happening at the moment.
Yes.
And I believe the Lord is saying, when I after that dream, I felt the Lord was saying to me that the church has the answer.
Come on
the church is anointed.
Yeah.
The church as the anointing to prevail in this hour.
Yes.
And I sense the Lord was saying to me that people are going to come to the church to look for answers.
Yes.
Because the government cannot give you answers.
Yes.
In this hour.
Yes.
Only the church, only the Lord can give you.
Yes.
That divine answer. And people are looking to the church and saying, what is happening?
Wow.
But you have been anointed.
Yes.
The body of Christ has been anointed.
Yes.
In this hour.
Yes.
You know, they turn to Joseph, they turn to Daniel for
yes.
answers, saying, what is God saying?
Oh,
because in the natural, I'm turning to natural
yes.
resources,
yes.
and they cannot give me the answers.
Yes.
But the church shall arise.
Yes.
And I see the Lord saying, the church needs to be
yes.
loud.
Yes.
The church needs to
yes.
be prevailing
yes.
in this hour,
yes.
not to be quiet. This is the hour
come
for the
on.
Prevailing church.
Yes.
And this is the greatest move of God
yes.
that's going to take place in the earth in this moment.
Even as my wife is sharing the scripture that comes to me, is Proverbs 3, verse 5 and 6. The Bible says, trust in the Lord with all your heart.
Yes.
And lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct your path. And in a few days, I mean in South Africa in the last few days, but in the nations in the last few weeks, the world has been turned upside down.
Yeah.
Because people has been trusting in things that is not God. People has been trusting in idols. They've
yes.
been trusting, they've been putting their trust in their wealth. They've been putting their trust in their own mm. legacies. They've been
yeah.
putting trust in their own structures. They've been putting trust in themselves. They've been putting trust in their earthly assets. They've been putting trust in their own earthly wisdom. They've been putting trust in human things. They've been putting trust in man. But the Bible says, put your trust in
yes,
the Lord.
Yes, yes.
And right now, in the last few weeks, the world has been turned upside down. People woke up and
yeah.
their lives has changed,
that's
has transformed.
Right.
The things they used to hold on to,
yeah.
they can't hold on no longer. The things that they used to think could save them,
mm.
can't save them anymore. The things that they thought that would help them, could not help them anymore. And the playing fields has just become level because rich or poor, everyone is facing the same thing. And right now, it's faith. It is the word of God. It is, and that's why this is 21 days of unlocking
yeah,
your faith.
Right.
Because we cannot be in fear,
that's
because
right.
fear will paralyze you, but faith is the vaccine, it's the antidote
yes,
against
yes,
fear
yes.
And we're going to just keep speaking faith
yeah.
we're going to keep, you will see on this broadcast, we don't want to speak just statistics and
no.
we don't want to speak negative
no.
we are not here to come and declare what's negatively happening. We don't even want to go into all these, you know, there's so many people that saying it's the end, we've come to the end and it's the last days. And yes, I know we are living in the last days,
yeah.
but I don't want us to be the church right now
mm.
to pray that we want to go to heaven. We want to be the church right now that says, Lord, let us be the light. Let us be the salt. The world is facing a dark situation and it's time for the church to shine. Come on. While we're in the earth, we're going to do what God has called us to do, and we're going to do everything, and His power and His glory will be manifested in the earth. Come on, give God a praise there where you are. Hallelujah. We give
you
praise.
This morning as I was praying, I was just listening to
yes.
break every chain, and
yes.
I sense the Lord was saying, I'm breaking chains over nations.
Yes.
I'm breaking chains over
yes.
nations. I'm breaking the yokes over
yes,
nations.
Yes, yes.
I'm breaking chains over homes, because there was a season
yes.
where the enemy had kept us in chains. But
yes.
I just sense the Lord said, I'm breaking chains
come
over
on
nations. It was a prophetic song that He gave
yes,
me this
yes.
morning. I'm breaking chains
yes.
over nations. The anointing will break.
Yes.
The anointing of Jesus, the
wow.
anointing of heaven will break every chain over every nation. I believe that we will not be in bondage, but we are free, because God has called us to be free, to be liberated, and the chains are breaking, the
yes,
chains
yes,
of infirmity,
yes, yes.
the walls are coming
yes,
down, and the
yes.
Lord took me to another verse, He
yes.
said, the walls are coming down, and I just saw walls of fear, walls of stress, walls of anxiety, walls of pain, walls of infirmity, walls of worry, anxiety, shame, pain, those walls are
coming
down. I saw the Lord said, I'm I'm breaking down the walls. I'm pulling it down in Jesus' name. And I want to decree that word over you that the walls are coming down, that the chains are breaking in this hour, that the chains are breaking over the nation of South Africa, over our communities, over the nation, over the whole earth. The chains are breaking and the walls are coming down in Jesus' name. What looks like a disaster, God is just rearranging the order. God is bringing divine alignment in the midst of chaos, what we see as chaos. God is a mysterious God. God's ways are not our ways. And so He's realigning, He's shifting the order in this hour in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
Come on, it's so amazing. In fact, Brother Terrence, it seems like you've seen my notes because I see you are sharing there about the anointing will break the yoke.
Yeah.
Come on, Isaiah 10:27. The Bible says, and in that time there will be a yoke, but it's the anointing that will break, that will destroy the yoke. Right now over the nations of the world, there is a yoke. And it's only the anointing of God that can destroy that yoke. And that's why this morning we're going to share with you about walking in the anointing, understanding the anointing, have an understanding that you are already anointed. There are just some things you need to do to activate and to release that anointing, but you already anointed. The anointing of God, when you receive Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, the Holy Spirit came to live in your heart. So right now, the anointing is upon you, but we want that anointing to increase and to increase. In fact, I want to encourage you in these 21 days, get a notebook out, get your phone out, get your notepad out, just make some notes, write it down, because these 21 days is going to prepare you for what God wants to do in and through your life. He's right now working in you, and then He's going to be working through you. So we have, in fact, I just saw a testimony now from Elder Val that said that we prayed last night about healing for backs and back pain. She said this morning she could praise God with us on boom. Come here, there. Come on, that's right, man. You see, could praise God with us because you see the devil wants to make you sick so that you can't do what God has called you to do. But this morning we rebuke sickness, we rebuke pain. Please, beloved, never believe the lie that the Lord has made you sick to humble you. That's not biblical. The Bible says He's the healer. He's the God that heals you. Come on, He's the healer. He's Jehovah Rapha. He's the Lord our healer. He's Jehovah Shalom. He's the Lord your peace. Last night when we were praying, I just sensed so much peace being released. Right now, I want to just say the peace of God is your portion. Come on, when His peace hits you, suddenly it settles things in your spirit and in your heart. The things that used to unsettle you will no longer unsettle you, because the peace of God will be like a canopy over your life.
I just sense the Lord say that you are anointed to conquer and you are anointed to overcome.
That's right.
And even in this hour, that I'm just going to just show you how great my anointing is.
Yes.
And the Lord says that greater is He that's within you than He that's in the world. And so don't be overwhelmed by what you see, because I'm about to show you how great and how strong my anointing is.
Yes.
You have spoken about my anointing. You've read about my anointing.
Yes.
But now you'll see how my anointing will be manifested in your life. But not only in your life, but you'll see how the anointing will be manifested in this nation and in your homes and in your children. Mm. Because I've sent my anointing, and I just see a big jar of oil that God is just pouring out on the nation of South Africa. For the anointing will destroy, the anointing will heal, the anointing will give peace, the anointing will break that chain, the anointing will break the anxiety. And the Lord says, I'm sending my anointing to give you peace, to give you peace, to give you peace in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Father, for your anointing. I thank you, Lord, that you anointed your children for such a time as this, in Jesus' name.
It's amazing. I was looking now, Melissa Phelps, writing here about, you know, in the midst of our trouble, there's a divine appointment. Wow, Melissa, such an accurate word. That when you study the Bible, when you study the scriptures, every time a man or woman of God found themselves in a crisis, it was not a crisis, it was virtually a divine appointment. You see, David was anointed in secret, but Goliath Huh. Goliath was the divine appointment to release publicly what God has done privately. Woo! Come on, in these 21 somebody. Days, you are being anointed,
yes.
and the anointing is increasing in your life in private, because publicly you're going to display the power of God. But God is rearranging the order. He's rearranging the order in the body of Christ. He's rearranging the order in the church. People will not be appointed based on reputation, based on education, based on my family. No, people are going to be appointed based on the anointing.
Yeah.
Come on, the anointing will bring the appointment, because God's anointing is now releasing a power in the earth, and is raising up a generation and a people that will be bold, that will be courageous, that will be fearless, that will be full of faith. And in your trouble, there is a divine appointment. When Esther and the nation is facing a crisis, God says, it's your divine appointment, Esther. When Abram and Sarah can't have a child, God says, Abram, I'm making a covenant with you. Because of your crisis, I will reveal Christ to you. Come on, isn't God an amazing God, that He will reveal His power to us in the midst of our crisis? Because He needs to get our attention. Because as people, we get so busy, we get so occupied. I've been speaking for years about that word busy. B-U-S-Y. Why? Being under Satan's yoke. The devil says, I can't stop you from being saved, so I'm just going to get you so busy and so occupied that you can't be effective. But I believe in this 21 days, God is resetting His church. He's resetting the order. He is saying that lose the busyness. Don't be busy. When people ask me, oh, pastor, you're so busy, I say, no, I'm not busy. Don't say that to me. I'm fruitful. I want to be effective. And I want to be doing the kingdom. Matthew 6:33. Seek ye first the kingdom of God, His righteousness, and all the other things shall be added. Amen.
Yeah, the anointing is not to look good. The anointing is not for ourselves, but the anointing is to produce and to be in service.
Yeah.
The anointing needs to produce something.
Come on now.
That's why in Luke 4 and Isaiah 61, it says that the Spirit of the Lord is upon you.
Wow.
For He has anointed you. God has anointed you for what? Anointed you to set the captives free.
Yes. Yes.
To bring healing, miracles, to be a vessel.
That's right.
You're a vessel of the anointing, and God has called you. And I just sense the Lord was saying that He has anointed you for assignments.
Yes,
even
right.
Even where you are at now, God has prepared you.
Yes.
And it's amazing that the Lord said that about secret place.
Yes, yes.
And that's what I felt the Lord was saying to me.
Yes.
He says, I prepared you in the secret place for this time. So God
Come
has
on.
Anointed you for this assignment. God will never bring you to a place and not give you the tools and not give you the preparation. God is already within you.
Wow.
It's already within you. God has already spoken to you.
Yes.
And I believe that this is a season for something new things to be birthed.
Wow.
God is birthing new things through you.
Yes.
You're going to start putting your fingers on that keyboard again.
Yeah.
Your fingers on the guitar strings.
Yes.
You're going to start writing again.
Wow.
Because that has been dormant and you just like left it because of hurt or pain or whatever it's been.
That's right.
But God is going to restore that, because He's anointed you with that gift. He's given you that gift for service, to set the captives free.
Wow.
Not just to preach, but there's so many other things that God has anointed you to do. And I just pray that God is going to revive that anointing this morning. He's going to revive that anointing this morning, that you will not see yourself as mediocre, but God is going to produce something mega in your life. God has not called you for mediocrity, but God has called you for the mega. For the mega, for the big.
Yes.
God is going to do big things in your life.
Oh,
the
best is yet so powerful,
come.
So powerful.
Big things to come. Big things.
It's amazing. Amazing. You know, I read some of these comments, and I mean, you guys, there's so much prophetic gifting flowing.
Yeah.
In fact, there's a lady, a Geraldine Koopman. I know she's from South Africa, but she's been living for years now in New Zealand. And as you're writing that God is breaking the chains of nations, I want to say to you, Geraldine, God has not sent you to New Zealand just for
That's
work
right.
and just for a better opportunity,
That's right.
but He has sent you to New Zealand to go and pull down those strongholds.
Come on,
there's a lot of false worship in New Zealand. And right now, God has called you and your family and those around you to bring the power of God to New Zealand. Right now, there are nations that's been worshiping idols that's been brought to their knees. Come on. Within weeks, there are nations. There are governments that's releasing. I just saw that America is releasing $2.2 trillion for help and for relief. But can I tell you right now, as much as we pray for God to remove this plague and to destroy this virus and to heal the nations, I want to say that money cannot solve this problem. This is a spiritual thing. You see, too many times we've tried to fix spiritual things with natural ways. But this is, the Bible says in 2 Corinthians 10:3-5, that God says that our weapons, come on, your weapon of warfare, it's not carnal, but it's mighty through God for the pulling down of strongholds. We have the power to pull down strongholds. And right now, I speak that word, even as my wife spoke. I believe there's such an anointing over you, and God is calling everyone to step out. It's time for the church to step out and to step into our calling, to step into our purpose, and to step into our destiny.
I just sense we need to pray for Geraldine Koopman right now. And pray for the nation of New Zealand.
Yes.
And so I just pray. Can we just come in agreement? Father, we just pray for Geraldine right now. We pray for our family, Father. As in the nation of New Zealand, Lord, that you've called her there for divine assignment. And Geraldine, the Lord has called you there for divine assignment. He sent you there to be the light and to be the salt and to bring the flavor and to bring the anointing and to bring the fire and to bring the glory. And the Lord says that he's going to give you an opportunity to minister. God is going to give you creative ideas. Even in this hour, you might not physically be able to reach people, but God is going to give you creative ideas. He's also going to give you favor. And the Lord says, don't become despondent, don't become weary, but the Lord says he's going to reignite that fire. And I just see that he's going to reignite that fire. I see like a fire and a flame coming up. The Lord says that you're going to set that community on fire. And so, Lord, we pray for the nation of New Zealand. We pray that they will call upon the name of the Lord. I pray for revival to break out in the name of Jesus. I pray, Lord, that the fire of God will touch, Lord, that nation. Oh, Lord, on the coast of New Zealand, on the inward parts of New Zealand, every community, Father God, that they will call on the name of Jesus in this hour. Father God, I pray, Lord, that you will just release your love on the nation of New Zealand, Father God. And you've called your sons, you've called this family, Lord, to be a blessing and to release your fire. So, Lord, we thank you, Lord. We believe it in Jesus' name.
Come on, in fact, as my wife is praying for New Zealand, we were planning to put up a map of the whole world, of the globe, and to pray for nations. But why don't we do it together right now, where you are? Right now, you are tuned in, you are watching us. Every nation that comes to your heart right now, come on, we're going to pray together, and I will start to mention the continents, and I will mention the different parts of the world. But I want you to come on, let's just lock arms right now. Let's lock in, because the Bible says that the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, and those who dwell therein. So the whole earth belongs to God. Amen. So right now, come on, the devil doesn't own any part. The devil is not a creator. Come on, he's a copycat. So right now, as we pray, I want you to start to pray right now. And I want you to start to call nations, as God mentions to you. Come on, we start with the continent of Africa right now. We pray for Africa, Lord, that Africa will be saved, Lord. Oh, come on, there's been a prophetic word that revival will start from the tip of Africa. Right here from Cape Town, there will be a revival that will start from the tip of Africa. So we bring all the nations. Come on, right now, mention the nations. Mention the nations right now. We pray for Tanzania. We pray for Zimbabwe. We pray for Nigeria. We pray for Ghana. We pray for Congo. We pray for Egypt. Come on, we pray for Mali. We pray. You come on, Burundi. You pray, you pray. As you pray, we say, Lord, we bring the nations of Africa. Botswana, come on, we pray. We bring all the nations of Africa before you. And right now, Ethiopia, Lord, we bring them before you right now. And we pray in the name of Jesus that Africa will be saved, Lord. Right now we pray for South America. Come on, that's right. We pray for Brazil. We pray for Argentina. Come on, we pray for Venezuela. Come on, we pray right now in the name of Jesus. We bring South America before you. And we pray right now for all the nations in South America. We pray for that continent to be saved in Jesus' name. We pray for North America. Come on, that's right. Now we pray for America, for Canada. We bring them before you right now, all the states in America. We bring them before you in the name of Jesus. And we rebuke every spirit of the enemy. And we pray America will be saved, Father. Right now, we also pray for the continent of Australasia, which is Australia and New Zealand. We pray right now that you move by your Holy Spirit. Oh, you break, Father, every idol worship, and you come to deliver the nations of this world, Father. We pray over Asia. Come on, that's right. We pray over Asia. We pray right now over India. We pray over Russia. We pray over China. Come on, we pray over all the islands around it. We come to bring them before you in the name of Jesus. We decree and we declare that you are the God that delivers the nations, Father. We pray for Europe. We pray for the UK, Father. Oh, so many people in Europe, they've been worshiping their wealth, Lord. But right now they realize their wealth cannot save them. There's only one that can save them, and his name is Jesus. John 14 verse 6, that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. Come on, we even pray for Antarctica. We pray for every continent, every nation of the world, and every one of these 6.9 billion people. And we bring them before you, and we declare that this world, oh, that God, you are the God that created the nations of this world, Father. And right now, Lord, every idol is broken down. Every false God is broken down. Every religious God is broken down. Every idol worship is destroyed, Father. Come on, right now, I mentioned this yesterday. Even the Pope came live to say that the people from the church doesn't have to go to the priest anymore. They can confess to God directly. That's right. That's what the Bible says. Come to the Lord. You don't have to come to a pastor or to a priest or to a bishop. You open your mouth and you confess to the Lord, and he will restore you. 1 John 1:9. The Bible says that God is able to forgive us and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Hallelujah. He's a good God.
God is doing. I don't know if you just sense, I just felt the compassion, and as we're speaking about and praying for Europe, I just felt my heart breaking for Europe and just to see what's happening. But I believe that God can take whatever the enemies mean for evil, that God can shift and God can turn this around. And so we never want to be judgmental in this hour.
We don't
want to be self-righteous in this hour. We want to be prayerful in this hour. We don't want to point fingers. But God wants us to pray. The
full
church
of love.
Needs to pray.
Come on, we need to be full of love.
Because love covers. Love covers a multitude of sin. All of us have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. But God is able.
Come
he
on.
Sent his only son. What? Not to condemn the world, but to save the world.
Yes. Come on now, that's powerful. In fact, I saw Brother Samuel Festus commenting, he's got the whole world in his hands.
That's right.
Remember that song, he's got the whole world in his hands. Brother Samuel, even for you, I want to just speak this word. There's such a calling and an anointing on you to preach the gospel. You know, as an evangelist, as someone that tell people about Jesus. And I want to say to you, don't stop. Keep speaking the word. You know, people of God, as my wife was sharing Isaiah 61 and also Luke chapter 4 verse 18 and 19. Come on, before we wrap up today, I want to just read for you Luke chapter 4 verse 18 and 19. Because this is really the job description of the believer. That's the job description of the church. You know, when you start a job, then people ask, can I get my job description? I need to know what is expected of me. So right now in this 21 days, God is reminding us, what is your job description? Because there are things that's keeping us busy, that's not our job description.
Yes.
There are things that we're running around for, that the time when we need to face Jesus in eternity, it's going to count nothing for us.
Yeah.
But God says, and the enemy is after the anointing and the calling of your life.
That's right.
The devil is not after anything else,
that's
because he knows if he can shut you up, if he can quiet you, if he can keep you occupied with a lot of other things, that you will not be able to do what God has called you to do. But I believe God is changing the order, and people are going to start to pursue the purpose and the plan of God like never before. And because you will realize in 21 days, that thing that I thought is so important, it's not important.
Right.
I've lived without it for 21 days.
Yeah.
So maybe it's not so important. Maybe it's more important for me just to get into the assignment of God, the kingdom assignment. Luke chapter 4 verse 18 and 19, a favorite portion of scripture. In fact, the prophet Isaiah, more than 2,000 years before Jesus is born, he prophesies and he starts to say, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. He prophesies this exact scripture. Now understand that Jesus comes in Luke 4, and he is the fulfillment of that scripture. And he stands in the temple and he says, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me.
Yeah.
Because he has anointed me.
That's right.
To proclaim the good news to the poor.
Yeah.
He has sent me to proclaim liberty and freedom to the captives.
Yes, yes,
and to bring recovery of sight to the blind.
Mm.
And to set at liberty those who are oppressed. And to proclaim the Lord's favor. Don't just see that scripture in the natural. When he says open the blind eyes, it is in physical but also spiritually.
Yeah.
There are many that's been spiritually blind.
That's
now
right.
This here is our job description.
Mm.
You and I, we and you have been anointed to set the captives free.
Yeah.
And that anointing is in you. I want to give you one last scripture. And these scriptures we give you, you must please read them. It's your homework. You have a lot of time now. Isaiah 61, read the whole chapter. Luke chapter 4. And then also one last scripture I want to give you is Acts chapter 1 and verse 8. Remember, yesterday we spoke about the Holy Spirit and there was just such a shift.
Yeah.
The presence of God just moved. And now we speak about what does the Holy Spirit come to do? He comes to anoint you. What is the anointing? It's the unction to function. Because why does he bring, like my wife said, the anointing doesn't come for titles.
Yes.
It doesn't come because you want to have your picture somewhere.
Yeah.
The anointing doesn't come so that you can have this name. No, no, the anointing is for service. Jesus said, I came to serve you, not to be served. The anointing is to serve God's people. It is to make a difference in the world. And the Bible says in Acts chapter 1 verse 8, and Jesus said to them, don't go preach it. Wait in the upper room. In fact, the church was also in lockdown. Before the Holy Spirit came, they were in lockdown. Jesus said, you don't go and preach. You wait for him till he comes. And Jesus says in Acts 1 verse 8, but you shall receive power. That word power in the Greek comes from the word dunamus. Dunamus, which means explosive power. It's the same word you get the word dynamite from.
Yeah.
Come on, you already have dunamus, dynamite power on the inside of you. And listen to what he says. He says, you shall receive power to be my what? Not to be my apostles, to be my prophets, to be my pastors, to be my what? To be my witnesses. God is looking for the church to be witnesses that is anointed.
Come on,
anointed witnesses. And that's the word we want to speak over you today. That there is an anointing that's coming. Your prayer life is about to change. Your worship is about to change. The anointing of God over your children is about to change. The anointing of God over your house is about to change. The anointing over your life is increasing right now. Don't you want to just take a moment and just stretch your hand towards the camera? Take your right hand and stretch it toward the camera, because as you stretch your hand, I believe right now I want to release the anointing of God over the screen. Come on. It's the anointing that has prepared David. When Goliath came, the anointing gave him victory. Come on, the anointing is going to help you to build a strong marriage. The anointing is going to help you to raise your children. The anointing is going to help you to succeed at your workplace. The anointing is going to help you to operate and flow in the gifts of the Spirit. The anointing of God gives us access into the supernatural. Father, we thank you for your anointing.
Yes.
The Bible says it is the anointing that breaks the yoke.
Jesus.
I speak over your people now. A fresh anointing.
Jesus
an
name.
Increase of the anointing.
Jesus name.
A sensitivity to the Holy Spirit.
Name.
A sensitivity, Father,
Jesus.
To your voice.
Thank you,
a sensitivity, Lord,
thank you,
to the voice of God.
Yes.
A sensitivity, Father, even when they read the word, they will hear the Spirit of God speaking to them.
Yes.
And your anointing right now, we release it, Father, because there's power in the name of Jesus. Your anointing, come
thank
on.
You, Lord.
I just sense the anointing of God coming to that house. Because you see, there's a difference when you just sing a song and when you sing a song with the anointing. Because the anointing set the captives free. It delivers the drug addict.
Yes.
Come on now.
Yes.
It delivers you from every bondage and every burden.
That's
things
right.
that you struggled with, you just need the anointing of God
to
set you free. Oh, thank you for your anointing. Thank you for your anointing. Bora baba. Come on, let's just speak to them. To speak the anointing over the people.
Father, I just thank you right now.
There is power.
And there's power in your name.
Bar-a-ba-ba.
That Jesus, at the mention of your name, every knee must bow, demons must flee, bodies are healed. And so we thank you for that powerful name of Jesus. Jesus, there's no other name but the name of Jesus. Right where you are, I just want you to say the name of Jesus.
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 Jesus. There's such power that's released when we say the name of Jesus.
Jesus.
Lord, I pray, Father, that nations will call on this powerful name of Jesus. And so, Lord, we thank you that we just release that anointing.
Yes.
We release your favor. We release, Father God, your peace on your people this morning, Father God. And we thank you, Lord, that every chain is being broken.
Yes.
Every chain is broken. By faith, we receive that the bondages and chains are broken. And so
it's
we're going to end off this morning.
Come on, Lord, it's right.
If you have any prayer requests
send
or you have
any
testimonies,
yes.
Inbox us, message us on 076-448-7988.
That's right. We want to release the anointing against this virus, this coronavirus.
Yeah.
We want to release the anointing to break and destroy the yoke that is over the nations now, over South Africa,
yeah.
over our nation. And we release the anointing to break that yoke
yes.
in Jesus' name. God bless you. We love you. Send your prayer requests. Send your testimony. Saying there is power in the name of Jesus. Have an awesome Monday. He's a good God. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain. Army, come on, it's right. You are the army of the Lord. Rise up, army. There's an army rising up. I'm on you, the army of the Lord. Every chain is broken over your home. Every chain is broken over your family. Every chain is broken over your children. Every chain is broken over your finances. Every chain is broken over your body. Every chain is broken over your calling. Every chain is broken over your destiny. Every chain is broken. Broken. Broken.
right now. Chain is broken in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord. Beloved family, loved ones, we thank God for you. Keep praying. It's going to be a Monday of miracles.
It's going to be a week of miracles.
Come on now, that's
Amen.
Right. So we decree and declare
yes.
that the goodness of God is upon your life. I hear the change for
Come
you.
Come on.
Come on, my wife's going to speak the blessing.
Come on.
And we are looking forward to see you 9 a.m. every day of these 21 days. We keep going for
yes,
Jesus.
Yes,
Amen.
Yes, yes.
Hallelujah. God is good.
Father, I decree and declare that every person, Father, watching this, everyone that's associated in them, Father God, is blessed.
Yes.
We are blessed. We are a blessed nation.
Yes.
We are a blessed family. That nothing can curse us because we are blessed, Father God. And so, Lord, we release that blessing of the Lord upon your children, Father God. They shall lack no good thing, that they are protected. They are favored, Father God. They are provided for, Father. And I thank you, Lord, that today is going to be an awesome day. This week is going to be amazing. Mega miracles this week. We claim that word, Father God. Mega miracles in Jesus' name. We love you. We care for you. We pray for you. God bless.